Welcome to Dodge Rehab. Today we're going over the disassembly of the Dodge half-ton truck headlight assembly. These are relatively simple to do, but if you've got rust issues, it could also be a major pain. These are the best headlights I've ever worked on, condition-wise, so I figured now would be a good time to shoot some video. So let's go over the tools you're going to need. You're going to need a rubber mallet, two screwdrivers, flat blade, an adjustable wrench, and don't forget the WD-40. Step number one is remove the holding nuts and washers from the bottom of the entire assembly. These are what hold the entire thing to the fender of the truck. These came off pretty easily, but I will be cleaning all threads before I put the thing back together. There are four of them. There is a retainer clip in the front oriented towards the front of the headlight assembly. That's for the wiring harness. You're going to want to definitely keep that or make one if it's missing. The next step is to spray down the big retaining nut in the middle there that I just hit. I just sprayed everything because it was looking kind of rusty. I was worried that this wasn't going to be easy. I'm spraying WD-40 in the crack here because that's going to be very important as I try to pull that retainer ring off of the assembly. Okay, the next step is get an 11/16 socket or your adjustable wrench. We are going to be pulling the bottom assembly off here. So that nut will just come loose and you just take it off. There's a lock washer underneath. Go ahead and pull that off. And what that's going to allow you to do is pull the entire bottom off as so. Pull it out and away and you are set to go. Now this one's in remarkably good shape. I can see a gasket was there between the fender and the assembly, but I don't know where to get a new one. So this is the light socket itself. All you have to do there is just twist it to the left and pull it out. At least it worked for me that way. Now this guy was a little bugger. This is the little retaining screw that's going to hold that front retaining ring to the headlight. This one was really buggered up. So I had to do some work off camera to get it to come loose, and it takes quite a few turns to get it loose, but eventually it will come out, hopefully. Usually you got to cut these, so I was very fortunate to get both out on both headlight assemblies. I'm looking around for my flat blade screwdriver. Now here's the trick. The flat blade screwdriver, you're going to want to get it in between the headlight bucket and the retainer ring and start gently prying back and forth, go all the way around. Again, I'm trying to do this with my camera in one hand and the screwdriver in the other, but you can see right there it's starting to come apart a little bit. That's a good thing. Just keep at it real gentle, and eventually it'll work itself loose. Now here I have it all the way loosened. I just wanted to pop it off for demonstration. You can see where the bottom is, that's where the screw goes, but there's nothing on the top, and what holds it in is on the bucket itself right there, that little raised part. That's what keeps the headlight retainer ring in place. So now the next step, possibly the hardest, there are four tiny screws. One, two, three, and four. They are flat blade, and those have to come out to remove the inner retaining ring from the whole assembly, and believe me, I could not do both on camera. So I removed the four little screws. Thank goodness they came out, and it just pops out. There, you don't have to turn it. You don't have to do anything. It just pops straight out. Now, this one's in remarkably good shape. I have not been this fortunate with other builds. I'm going to soak this in evaporust and kind of set it aside, and that's all I'm going to do to it. Maybe give it a shot of paint before it goes back in. So we're going to lay that aside. Then the headlight just pops right on out. It's that simple. Theoretically. So let's have a look at what's going on back here. Just unplug the headlight. Boom. That's all you got to do. And the headlight is free. We tested the headlights, and the high beams work and the low beams don't. There is a high-low beam, so we will be replacing those headlights. Now let's have a look at the wiring itself inside. You can see right where I zoomed in there, that is the ground wire. It grounds right to that screw. It grounds right to the headlight bucket. Really, really not complex. The next step is to remove that large adjustment bolt. And I struggle with it a little bit here, but hopefully you can see. By the time you get it disconnected from the bottom and all that, I can free turn that bolt very easily. So what you're going to want to do is just gently rock it back until the lip of the bolt head gets out from underneath that holding retainer piece, and it just comes straight out. And I fumble with it a little bit here and there, trying to get the pieces out. But there will be a retaining bolt, that long bolt, and this washer. The washer goes underneath the bolt, and that's what lets you adjust the headlight so that you can adjust the beam so it's properly focused. Neither one of those had paint on them when I removed them. And there again, that's the example where the ground goes and it goes into that socket. Now, to get that socket out of there, I just flipped the bucket over and I just punched it out with my screwdriver. It was not too hard to do, but I wasn't able to get it on camera. So once you flip it over, take your screwdriver, punch it through, you're done. And that's it. You're ready to take it to sandblasting. These cleaned up absolutely beautifully, and I am so excited to show the finished product. Thanks a lot, and hope you guys do well with your projects.